Okay, so let's get to this. As you guys know, I haven't painted in about a few months, right? And that sucks because I really want to be doing this and I have been thinking about this for so damn long. All right, so let's get to that. So yesterday when I was taking a nap, I got this epiphany. So I was thinking, shit, the reason why I haven't actually painted in my life before, I'm shaking the camera because I'm touching the stand thing. Right, so the reason why I haven't taken on painting before is because I don't like flexibility of a brush. The fact that the end point is flexible is what freaks me out. Also, the paint on it makes the end a lot thicker, and that also freaks me out because then I feel like I don't have control on what's happening here. Also, I'm a micro artist, so when I do a portrait, for example, I take white paper and I put it, let's put this down. So I take white paper and I put it a square around the area that I'm using to draw, and then I zoom in with my eyes, and this has actually caused problems with my eyes, but anyhow. So I zoom in with my eyes and I only have, literally I have like this area to work with, and then I know where I am. In my brain I have the full picture, but in my head I know that if I do zoom in, then these micro little movements need to be made to get the picture as realistic as I want it. But with paint you can't do that. With paint you have to take a completely different approach, like what I've done here. You have to pick up different colors with one brush and put it on at the same time, and just, I don't know, somehow it just creates the shadows, you know? And I don't know how to do that yet. So I figured, why not try something else, something different? Okay, so I don't know if it's gonna work, but what I did today was I took my mixing sticks, just ice cream sticks that I bought from the supply store, and I cut them up in a few different shapes. So I have a pointy one, I have a flat one, and then I have a half flat, pointy, flat, whatever. I have this one. And I also have a, we call it a sassati stick for kebabs, like a kebab stick. That makes sense, right? Please don't look at my nails, they're disgusting. So I have this for really, really small ends. So I'm gonna try this today because, you know, it's all about experimenting, and experimenting is what's gonna get you to do what you wanna do at the end of the day. Also, another thing that I'm trying is I dug up my old acrylic paints that I use for murals, that I have used for other murals. I think they're also a lot more pigmented, and I do have a problem with the red that I bought, the kind of red. As you guys know from my previous videos, the red is not as pigmented as I would like it to be. It's not a true red. So this one is a true red, and it might help me to get the colors that I want. And also, this is a true blue. I also don't have a true blue, which is also something that has been frustrating me, because my greens are not getting true and my oranges are not being true. And that's, it's really annoying to me, because this painting is supposed to be a rich autumn painting with lots of bright orange and green colors. So so I want to try and maybe do it with these, just for the foreground details, for the tree bark, and because the tree is supposed to be four foreground, like the first thing you see, it's supposed to pop out, right? The tree and the autumn leaves, which is going to go up there and on the floor. So I want to try and just do the fine details maybe with this, and then I'll continue with the background later when I know what I'm gonna have to do here, because I'm still thinking about it and I'm still struggling with this part right here, and it will come to me as it does with all things. So without further ado, let's try this and hope for the best. Alright, so I'm actually in the shot. Wait, where's my head? I'm in the shot. Alright. Sorry. Okay, so first thing, I need to take my hand out of this light. So first things first, I have to remember sun is coming from this side, because we forget these things, right? That it wipes off, don't worry about it. Then I have my little very old mixing thing. I'm gonna start with, oh, these colors are very old. The last time I painted a mural for someone was, gosh, I actually have no idea, very long ago. So I don't know if these paints, oh, they're still, they liquid. Perfect. Right, okay, so I have a brown and I want white. This white might not be liquid, I don't know. It's been close though, but I have some more white. The white's fine, the white is true. Put the white in the middle. Oh, it's the liquid, I'm so happy. Okay, so very little in here. I know exactly where. I have like a very big tub of true white and it's a thick solid white, but it's in the garage. My sister used it. Gosh, I'm really not in the mood to go all the way to the garage. So I have that, and then yellow, and red. I don't have red, I'm going to make this one red. And this one, oh my gosh, blue. Oh, this one's going to be blue. Oh, black, yes, this is black. This is black. It's too much. It's fine. And the gray. Put this one in the green one. Oops. Okay. So now we have colors on the other side of the light. Oh, I have no idea what I'm doing. Okay. So, in my head, I'm gonna have to just think what this is going to look like. So let's start with a brown. Let's start just drawing some shapes. I need my foot to be a little bit more taller, but anyways. Okay, so we're going to start on the side. What does tree bark look like on the side? Oh, I couldn't see this. That's why we use brushes, because the paint doesn't stay on the stick. Maybe use the flat one. This one? See, I'm just experimenting, so I didn't know if this was gonna work. You never know until you try, right? That's the idea. I'm gonna use this one. You have to try. Okay. Oh, do you know how much it sucks painting without music? But YouTube has this thing where they just like tell you, oh, we're just gonna delete this video because you're copywriting, when there's like background music. If you don't like list it in your video, kind of sucks. I wanna do this. Make it. See if this works. Oh yes, that's the thing. That's what I'm looking for. Oh yes, stamp. I'm stamping it. That's a good idea. All right. So I'm trying to create these little diamond shapes, as you know, these big diamond shapes and our small diamond shapes, to just try and reference bark. I remember when I was very small, we have a park just around the corner on the next road, and I would look at the giant oak tree. And I really just studied the bark in detail because I thought it was just the most beautiful thing in the whole wide damn world. I just thought the bark was so freaking beautiful. And wow, it's making me realize, you know, I've been an artist since I was very, very small. I've always been interested in, you know, the way things look in detail. I've always had a very fine eye for detail. Pretty freaking amazing. Okay, so this is not working as I want it to be working. Crap. Why is it not doing what I want it to be doing? It's still thick. not doing what I wanted to be doing. Maybe I should have just like drawn this whole wall with pencil. You think that would have worked? I would have probably gone faster because I would have known what I was doing. And also, I would be wasting all of this money. Which I probably am, because most of my paints have dried. And I spent a lot of money on this paint already. It's kind of working. It's kind of working, kind of not. Maybe I should just focus a little bit more. Okay. So I am going to time-lapse now. Here we go. Dude, can you see that little... Let me just bring the light. Tiny piece of paint there. Oh goodness, I wish you could comprehend. There we go, it's more in focus. But it's very difficult for you to actually see. Maybe from the top, yeah, that's better. Focus. Okay, so it's very tiny detail, but basically, okay, let me put the light down and try and explain this to you. Get the light from... I'm really blocking the light with the camera right now. Okay, so I need my hand to explain to you what I was doing. So, I can't see on the camera, but okay. So let's look at that. So that is a tiny... Can you see? That's a bit better. Alright, that's better. So that is a tiny, tiny black and blue line. And then there's some little red spots. And there's some white over there. And there's some yellow over there. And then I blended the brown with all of the colors. I literally put down like the reds and the blues and the yellows, and I just blended it with this tiny little stick. So I'm gonna try and do it for you now. Okay, so now I need to try and hold the camera and the palette at the same time. That's gonna be interesting. And I'm blocking the light with the palette, so that's not working. Bottom. Blocking the light. Am I blocking the light? Okay, hope I don't drop this thing. And now my camera's not pointing where I want it to point. Okay, so it's gonna be skewed now, just for the time being. Right, so this is what I'm doing. I'm not necessarily gonna tell you what I'm doing because I need to focus. Okay, so that's brown. Just putting a base of brown. That tiny area. Okay, and then I'm adding white to the top and yellow to the bottom. Oh, that's too much yellow. So it's quite handy to have a cloth with you at this time. Okay, so I added some gray, and now I'm just moving the paint around, because essentially that is what painting is. It's moving the paint around and adding your colors. Maybe I should be an oil painter, because it seems like this is what they do with oil paintings. I should add red. See, now I have too much paint for this tiny little spot. But no fear. I shall just make it a bigger shape. Okay. It's not working. Why does it not work? Just because I'm trying to talk to you guys while I'm doing it. That's why it's not working. Okay, so move that around. I'm gonna shut up and try and focus on what I'm doing. Cool thing about bark is it's not all supposed to be the same shape or the same color, and that's kind of what makes it amazing. The fact that every single piece of bark can be a different color. Goodness, why did I not try this earlier? Okay, blue.
Mix. I feel like when I draw with a pencil, I also kind of just move around the dust with my pencil. Like when you do a charcoal drawing, it's essentially just you putting down some dust and then moving it around with a piece of tissue paper rolled up to a point. See? It's turning into brown. Wipe my stick on the white paint instead of taking pure white paint. So the idea is now to get the white paint to spread. It's making a pure color, that's beautiful. Wipe. Sorry. That's too much. Too much, and there's a hair. Why is there a hair? Oh. You guys know that I'm holding the camera with my hand, right? So I do apologize for the shaking. I shake quite a lot for an artist, but that's kind of part of being an artist. You eventually build up some sort of arthritis or something from all this fine, gross movements. Very good for your brain, I think. It's very relaxing, even though my neck is killing me. This looks amazing! Why does this look so amazing? I'm so proud. Oh, my eyes are watering because I'm not blinking. Blink. Oh. You guys, this is working. I can't believe this is working. Like a minute ago, I thought it was not working, but now I feel like it's working and it's looking really beautiful. I feel like I want to cry because it's so beautiful. Shit. How am I this good? Guys, I'm freaking myself out. How? How did I get this idea to do this? And it looks so cool. How amazing is this gonna look when the whole thing is this detailed? Oh. So you see what I'm doing there? I'm gonna do this for the rest of the day and just time up that shit. Holy guacamole, my neck is killing me. Thank you.
Alrighty, so this is what I have. Tiny little pieces of bark with different colors. I think it looks quite great. I love the texture that I have going on here. I think it's really gonna pop out when this whole tree is full of that texture. I know from far away it doesn't seem like much, but it really is gonna be the whole thing. But for now, thank you guys for tuning in. Like this video if you agree this is a good idea. And subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed the video. Subscribe to my channel if you love art. Just subscribe to my channel. I know you want to. I know you want to see more. I know this mural is very much far from done, but it's gonna be really amazing. It's really gonna look good. I mean, you see the amount of effort that I am putting in. So yeah, I hope you guys have a beautiful day and that you enjoyed the video, and yeah, that's it. Bye.